You're on
now. All right, folks, we're with you. Welcome to this week's Bible study and current events. We're glad you're there. I know a lot of y'all watching on the livestream.com, a lot listening on the phone number. By the way, if you will call and talk to us, the phone number you can call and talk to us if you want to, anytime during the teachings or the current events, is 304-591-6993. In case you're listening on the phone and don't see the number, you can hang up and call that number and talk to us if you want to, right?
That's correct.
Welcome to wherever you are. We're going to start off today, as always, in current events. And I always try to do something on the lighter side to start off with. I want to play a little clip for you here. That's about 3 or 4 minutes long. I think you'll find... You try to get Frank Lee's attention?
You're going to have to turn the volume up.
When I give it to you. Anyway, we're going to play a clip for you. This, I thought, was hilarious. You're going to feel kind of sorry for the young lady in some way, but you got to listen to this clip and then sit back and enjoy what's being said, okay? Go ahead.
Hi, is Michelle DePalma there, please?
This is her.
Hi, Michelle. Alan Tier from Midas Auto Care.
Hi, Alan.
Hi. Looking at your car, you brought it in for an alignment and a tune-up?
Yes, I did.
Yeah, we found a few more problems here. A little, you know, just...
Oh, you did?
Yeah, preventive maintenance. Kind of running by you, see what you think.
Okay.
Just make sure you want these done. First of all, the headlights.
The headlights?
Yeah, the headlight fluid's a little low. We're going to need to top that off.
Oh, okay, it is.
And right. That'll probably be about, well, it depends. Do you want the halogen fluid or the regular fluid?
Well, how much do they run?
Well, it's about $10 or $30. It's a question of quality, really. I mean, I wouldn't skip out. I'd go with the halogen.
The halogen is better?
Yeah.
Okay, and you said that was about $30?
Yeah.
Okay.
Each headlight.
Each headlight?
Yes.
Oh, so $60.
Yeah.
Okay, all right, we can go ahead and do that.
Okay, I'll mark that off. Good call, Michelle. Also, tires, I don't even know how this happened. This is weird. Somehow the left tires got on the right and the right tires got on the left. So you want us to switch those back around for you?
Yeah. Is that dangerous?
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
oh,
you don't want to be I mean, be thankful the front weren't on the back and the back weren't on the front. That could cause a real headache.
Oh, gosh.
But, well, sometimes the servicemen get confused maybe if you've had it in for service recently.
How much is that going to cost?
That's going to be about $50 per tire.
Per tire?
Yeah, we don't need to do the spare, though. We can leave that one alone.
Okay, so we don't have to do the spare, so...
Yeah.
What, so $100?
Yeah, $200.
Oh, $200.
Yeah, $50 a tire, and you'll be thankful. I mean, imagine you're going down the Southfield, and all of a sudden, whammo, hit a pothole. Big problems, yeah.
Okay, well, all right, we can do that.
Okay, and the biggest problem here, my guy checked it out, I don't know... Last time you were in for service, how long do you think it's been since you've had your car checked out?
I don't know, maybe about a month ago.
Yeah, I don't know how this happened. Maybe when you parked it at a mall or maybe in service, someone removed the transmission.
The transmission?
Yeah, it's just gone.
Don't you need that to...
Well, yeah, it improves gas mileage. I think you really probably need one. You want us to install a new one for you?
Well, if I really need one, how much is that going to cost me?
Well, it's going to be a bit. I'd actually get two for this type of car.
Okay, two?
Yeah.
Okay, how much is that going to be?
How often do you drive in reverse?
I guess just when I back out of my driveway.
Okay, can you park on the street maybe?
I could probably do that.
Okay, because no reverse function, that'll save you a few hundred right there.
Oh, it will?
Yeah, especially if you're getting two transmissions.
Okay.
So, let me...
So
I mean,
how much?
Well, there's one last thing.
Okay.
And this is purely cosmetic. This is really something, I don't know if it matters to you or not, but we noticed when we were in service in your car, the cigarette lighter was missing.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, we could throw that in. No charge, we could throw that in.
Really?
Yeah, if you want that.
Sure.
That'll just be $70 installation, but we won't charge you for the cigarette lighter.
Oh, okay.
So.
How much is everything going to be together?
Let me run up a total here. Let's see, you got the tires, halogen fluid. Lighter installation, okay, 836, carry the 2, and, okay, add that in there. Oh, labor, forgot the labor.
Right.
And, okay, Yeah. Okay. Good. Oh, this is great. This isn't too much damage then. We're talking about $2,440.
Oh my gosh, $2,400.
Yeah, that's not too bad. Actually, and that's great because the cigarette lighter you have, it's not a very expensive one.
Right. Well, you know, I need to call my dad to see if I can borrow some of the money.
Sure.
To help pay for it.
Okay.
And then could I call you back?
Yeah, actually, we might even have someone here that can help you out with that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, when you call us back, will you call us up at the new Q95.5? This is Mojo in the Morning, and you're a victim of a phone scam.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Hilarious.
And your dad was the one that set you up on this one.
My dad?
Yeah, your dad.
Oh, my gosh.
That's actually not Alan Terror. That's actually Spike from the show.
Oh, my gosh. I can't believe this.
And this is Mojo and Sarah.
Oh, no. I can't believe you guys did this.
I can't believe you're going to let us put a cigarette lighter in for $70.
All right, folks, I thought you'd enjoy that.
That was good.
That poor young lady, I tell you what, but hey, it's funny. That's just, it was. I mean, hope she was buying everything. Halogen fluid, I like that.
There's a lot of truth in that today.
Oh, I'm sure. Phil, we need to start a new business, man. We make a fortune. But anyway, let's get started in serious stuff now. But folks, you have to laugh. And when I saw that, I got to get that to Phil. We got to play it on the air. That is just worth listening to. It really is. Well, let's go to Proverbs to read a few scriptures, then get into what's going on. And we're going to try all this in an hour if possible. If not, we'll go longer than an hour. But Proverbs chapter 21. You know, to study this book and understand what it's saying to you and to get into it in a deeper way every time you go into it, it's just such a powerful enlightening. Mm-hmm. To what's happening today. But in chapter 21, verse 1, pay attention. The king's heart is in the hand of the Lord. Now, let that sink in a minute. He will take the leaders where he wants them to go, even to do evil, if necessary, to punish those who won't stand.
Yeah.
You see that?
Mm-hmm.
As the rivers of the water, he turneth it whithersoever he will. Every way a man is right in his own eyes.
Yep, leans to his own understandings.
How much clearer can that be? But the Lord pondereth the hearts. To do justice and judgment is more acceptable to the Lord than sacrifice. So pay attention. Mm-hmm. For us to do what's right is more acceptable to him than us to get up and say how much we love him and praise him. You understand that?
Mm-hmm.
Your praises and sacrifices, you offer the praise as a sacrifice, don't you? Without obedience and doing justice and judgment, your praises are shallow and empty and mean nothing to him.
I got to quote scripture on Hoppy's show. James, I forget what it is, 3:17 or something like that, but it's, to him who knoweth to do right and doeth it not, or no. To know it right and to do it not, to him it is sin.
Yes.
And that's what it is.
It is him. And for us to stand and praise him without obedience, remember I did this teaching years ago, Phil, obedience is sacrifice, sacrifice is obedience. If you don't have that in line, your praises are, I mean, they're dung, stink like trash in his nostrils. That's a fact. Mm-hmm. Let's get started. First off, I want to tell you that Lindsay Williams, a few nights ago, talked to Lindsay, and he just got back from the hospital in New Mexico, or Mexico, getting some things done. And I asked him, Lindsay, I hadn't talked to her about, is there anything new in her eyes? He said, no, Pastor Booth, there's nothing new. Everything I put out on the DVD, things due before September 15th, are still in line. Now, he's never, ever, ever said a date before. He just said these are generalities, are going to happen maybe within certain guidelines. Mm-hmm. He finally said that his friend told him that before the end of the year, something huge is going to happen that's going to change this country. Mm-hmm. So, I don't know what it is. I suspect it's economic, and he does too. Mm-hmm. I know that next week, the IMF is meeting and going to announce they're going to start using the yuan temporarily for the new world, or for the world currency, instead of the dollar. Now, if the yuan is taking the place of the dollar in the world currency, what's the dollar going to drop to now?
Zero.
No reason being good at all because nations have accepted. Now they're not. Mm. The yuan is going to take over for a while, but on September 25th, or October 25th, if everything goes the way plans, Christine Lagarde, the head of the IMF, will announce a new world currency that will do away with any type of, we'll say, currencies of the world. It will be one overlapping currency that they'll use for trade. It won't be physical, like paper or whatever. It'll be credits and debits.
Mm-hmm. So if it's one, we want a one ton?
You want, one ton of ones.
But the dollar's going to drop 3 cents down to zero.
Wow. Can we
That's
handle
not
that?
Really a big drop, two, really.
No, it isn't.
Dick, it's at 2 cents now.
It's at two right now.
It's going to drop 2 cents. Yeah.
But what's her name? Joan Vian told me years ago.
She was on Target.
Yes. They're going to go to debit credit system worldwide trade. They say it'll cut down on drug trafficking, slave trafficking, all that, because it's going to debit credit. I don't know how it's going to work. But when that happens, you can see the currency of the world, all of them. Well, not all of them. Some will go up, some will go down. Some come down drastically, and guess who's going to be one of the number one? Us. But anyway, also on nights on my station, we have Jeff Rentz on. Jeff Rentz has some good guests, and Jeff Rentz has some nuts on there. Mm-hmm. But he had a guest on named Zachary King. Zachary King had been to the Bohemian Grove 18 times.
18 times?
As a satanic high priest.
As a priest?
Yes. Whoa. Satanic. He's the one that rode across in the boat with the black hood and all that.
Oh.
That's him.
I'll be.
It's the one that done that. He is now a Catholic. He's not. I don't want to sound nasty, but he's not a Christian. He's a Catholic.
Yeah.
Okay, but it's better than being a satanic, I guess. But he said on the air, he said, Satan was the first Protestant. Martin Luther just popularized it. So anyway, he was there walking through the Bohemian Grove, and a guy named Alex was showing around the people he's going to be talking to. And he actually cast spells to help these people get money. True. I'm telling the truth here, okay?
I used to have a friend that their family during a full moon would go out and open their wallets and purses.
Oh, wow.
Really?
Yeah. To have them filled. Well, that's... Yep. That is not Christian.
Up here in Snowshoe, they pray the snow god, you know.
Yeah, they do.
But anyway, he said a man was walking towards him. He had an entourage of security all around him. So the man wouldn't get close. But the guy walked up to him and walked by. And Alex said, there goes a future president. This is 1994. And he said, can't be. He's a black man. It's Obama.
Oh, my.
These things are scripted.
Yeah.
Way ahead.
So that's interesting.
You remember Doc Marquis?
Oh yeah, I did have a program about that.
It was a similar situation where, you know, he was in there and he saw what they were doing, and he was actually to be used for Satan worship.
Yep, he was. He was the seventh generation, the seventh son.
Mm-hmm.
But this is something that people. This is 1994. Obama was elected in 2008. 14 years before his time for him to be president, he'd been groomed.
Yeah.
You know, only Satan can script that.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Only Satan.
So, anyway, but Zachary King, I'm going to get him on the program. I don't like his attitude. He's got a kind of cocky, but he has some information we need to share. He's going to be on the program discussing this. But he said it flat out, everything that happens is scripted. Now, I won't get into other issues on the air about what he said about some talk show hosts that were in there and how that was. Hey, I won't get into that right now. But anyway, it's just amazing how deceived we are.
Yes.
Anyway, I thought you might enjoy this. They finally found that, you remember Sergeant Schultz?
Mm-hmm. Yes. Uh-huh.
I know nothing.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. They finally found his daughter.
Looks just like him, really. I see a resemblance.
Yeah, you do.
Sure does.
So anyway.
Looks like a puffer
fish. She's an arrogant. Mm-hmm. Yeah, too.
Yeah. Anyway, let's move on. I'm going to have this guy on the program soon. Y'all know who Larry Klayman is?
Oh, Judicial Watch.
Yeah, he used to be a with the Department of Justice attorney.
Mm-hmm.
He has started a deportation movement on Obama.
Oh, I heard.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he said that Klayman's got a 20-page deportation petition, and he's getting it to the director for the U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement. A fraud detection director of DHS, and they're asking to remove Obama from office. It says that there's prima facie evidence that Barack Obama, Hussein Obama, is removable from the United States and in violation of law under the legally recognized categories of falsely claiming U.S. citizenship. Even if a legitimate birth certificate exists, Barack Obama's repeated use of a clearly forged birth certificate is still a crime, Clayton says.
Well, if you're going to deport him, I'd say give him a paddle and a kayak.
Yeah, there you go.
So I just gave him a paddle on an inner tube.
So I thought kind of, it won't go anywhere. But you remember that the lawyer was trying to get Obama arrested ever since been in office. What was her name, lady?
Our pair?
No, this is a lady.
A lady.
Yeah, I can't remember her name. You know, she tried, but they had, even had state judges said they're going to do it, then they backed out.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. This won't go anywhere. But it is more proof that some people are getting their eyes open. Lieutenant Governor Don Ramsey got in trouble because he said he's called for Christians to arm themselves after the gunman who killed 9 students in Roseburg, Oregon, asked him first what the religion was, if they were Christians, he shot them. So this Lieutenant Governor Ron Ramsey said, Christians, arm yourself.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Yeah.
But in the state of Tennessee, where he's from, the only way you can arm yourself is you have a concealed carry permit. It gives you permission to open carry.
Well, yeah, and the governor can't. He can try to get the legislature to act, but he can't do anything about that. Mm-hmm. You know.
This is an article written by Coach Dave Dalmar. I shared some of these in the air the other night. Let's play 20 questions, and I'm going to read them all. But I just want to review them to you. Coach has a pretty good grasp of what's happening, and he's not afraid to ask questions. If an unborn baby is not alive, why are its body parts of value? It's just a blob of tissue. Mm-hmm. What body parts? If the Tea Party folks are so racist, why do they support Ben Carson? Just questions.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Why are there no Protestants on the U.S. Supreme Court?
That's true. Not a one.
Catholics, Jews,
and
lesbians. Just curious. Is there any country in the world where LGBT, blacks, Hispanics, and women, Muslims, or other minorities have more rights than they do in the U.S.?
Wow. We're leading the pack.
Mm-hmm. Trying to find them here. If paying taxes is voluntary, why do you go to jail if you don't volunteer to pay them? Good question. Are societal standards determined by a vote of unelected judges? Well, they have been. They are.
Mm-hmm.
If homosexuals are born that way, how about pedophiles, bisexuals, and bigots? If it's hateful for a Christian to speak out against homosexuality, why is it not hateful for a homosexual to speak out against Christianity? Good question.
PC.
If Planned Parenthood is so concerned about women, and since they receive $500 million in government aid, why aren't the abortions free?
Hmm.
If homosexuality and cigarette smoking are both behaviors, why do our schools approve of one and disprove the other?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I think the word's hypocrites.
I think you're right. Anyway, that's enough of that.
Yeah.
And why do the names Common Core and Communism sound so much alike?
That one
got my attention the other night when you read that on your
National Geographic magazine, I thought it was interesting. There's a picture here. You can see it there.
Mm-hmm.
Some people standing in front of an old house back in the 1800s.
Mm-hmm.
A lady bought it at a yard sale. To find it here.
About the house?
No, about the picture.
Oh.
A 4x5x10 type. This is a California shop, and she bought it for $2 in 2010. They found out that Billy the Kid was in it right there.
In the picture?
Yeah.
Whoa.
Right there.
Oh.
And the picture sold for $2.3 million.
Oh.
Wow.
Oh.
Now that's a profit, man.
Good investment.
That's almost a $2 million profit.
Exactly.
Huh.
Anyway.
That'd be better than playing FanDuel.
Mm-hmm. I want you to, this is of course Bernie Sanders, openly outright communist socialist, but he's actually gaining ground in the Democratic Party. And it has the gospel according to Bernie. And folks, I just stop and think what we're seeing here.
Mm-hmm.
Talk about a mind
manipulation.
Yes,
yeah.
And brainwashing has happened in this country.
Mm-hmm.
But they would even consider man this perverted and evil. Think about that.
Or to tie gospel to a person.
Yes, exactly.
You know, you can't tie gospel to anybody.
Just think what that would have been like if we'd done that 50 years ago, Phil. And this is telling. The new Roman Empire.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, the people, just so many tears were shed with that event.
Yeah.
People actually took his water glass.
Look what he's in. He's in probably a gunproof.
It is.
I don't know. They called it the Pope Mobile. Yeah. They said it was just some little Fiat.
Jeep.
Doesn't look like a Fiat to me.
It's
a Jeep. Oh, okay. Well, still.
But, you know, if you think about it, I don't care what sect you take right now. If Christ came back, most likely they would crucify him if they could.
Well, yeah, it's very true.
And he would upset their apple cart.
He asked in the scripture, when I come back, will I find faith on the earth? Mm-hmm. Some good news. An Illinois teen put her life on the line to save a man whose motorized scooter had become stuck on a railroad crossing just as the train was approaching. I say Aldridge, 19, said that when she heard Earl Moorman shout for help, she didn't think twice and ran to the tracks as the crossing arms lowered. After struggling with the wheelchair, she lifted the 200-pound man out and dragged him to safety. Just as I pulled him back, the train hit his wheelchair, she said. His wheelchair was exploded. Mormon's son-in-law, Dave Beck, rushed to thank Aldridge. I've hugged her I don't know how many times, he said. There's still some people left with some courage.
Mm-hmm. Out of that, she only being 19 years old, it's like an adrenaline rush,
yeah.
And she could actually
pick him up.
What was he doing crossing on a wheelchair?
I guess just crossing traffic.
Trying to get the other side, you know what they say.
Yeah.
Why did the chicken cross the tracks?
Yeah,
but see, he was crossing at an actual crossing. Somehow he got hung up between the tracks.
Yeah.
In the
only in America.
Could have had a flat tire.
Mm-hmm. A Maryland middle school student is facing assault charges for kissing a female classmate. Police say the 13-year-old boy pulled the girl toward him and kissed her on a dare from another classmates. The unidentified eighth grader was arrested and charged with second degree assault. He also faces suspension or expulsion. Eighth grade. I just said middle school.
Oh, middle school, okay.
I mean, come on.
Madness.
Don't we have better things to... No.
Bad week for hard evidence after a Chinese woman accused of stealing a $400,000 diamond from a Bangkok store was forced to undergo a colostomy. The 6-carat stone was found in her large intestine.
Ooh.
I'll tell you, you remember there was a movie called Running Man?
Oh, yeah.
And there were diamonds involved?
Yeah.
And he made the guy swallow the diamonds, and that was death because it was going to tear up his...
Yeah, insides.
Insides.
Wow.
A British man has been labeled the world's stupidest bank robber after he pulled a knife on a teller and demanded she deposit money in his personal account. Paul Niverson, 61, gave the teller his name and told her to put $800 into the account and fled when she hit an alarm. He then tried the same stunt in another bank just 400 feet away. The bungling robber was arrested at the scene and sentenced to 2 years in prison. It was ridiculous, Niverson's lawyer said of his client's bank robbing technique. It's only had one ending, and here it is. So, okay, don't put it in your personal account.
Or that, or else he wanted back in prison to be taken care of.
That's good, yeah. Mm-hmm. I thought, yeah, this Pope thing, by the way, has been, all out of whack. Only in America, Doritos launch of a limited edition of your rainbow chips as part of a campaign to combat suicides among LGBT teens that sparked a backlash.
$10 a bag.
$10 a bag?
That's what had on there.
Yes.
Critics declared a boycott of the Doritos, while conservative pundit Ed Straker called the chips a gateway snack designed to entice children into becoming gay. What business does Doritos owners, Pepsi Company, have pushing homosexuality with our kids? That's a good point, but they're doing it.
Well, it's our responsibility to look and see what we need to buy.
It is. Mm-hmm. Good week for sing-alongs after a federal judge ruled that the song Happy Birthday to You is no longer protected by 1935 copyright. Do you know all those years you sang that, you were breaking the law?
That's right.
Yep.
A California publishing company has raked in $2 million a year enforcing that copyright. Since 1935. Bad week for arachnophobia. After an Indiana woman backing out of her driveway jumped out of the moving car when she saw a crawling spider on her shoulder, sending a car crashing into oncoming traffic. I don't think we can charge her with reckless driving, said the local sheriff, because she wasn't in control of the vehicle. Okay. And this, I thought, for a national magazine, was a bit risque, even though it's about breast cancer. I thought that was a bit much for a fellow magazine.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay, that's just a bit much, don't you think?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, really. On Time?
Yeah, Time magazine. Light up here. Look at this picture right here. You notice anything odd? Obama's holding his hand out to shake hands. He refused to shake his hand.
Yep.
That's right.
Did he actually not shake his hand?
He didn't shake his hand.
In that article I was showing Bush this morning, the same thing was spoken in there. He refused to shake Obama's hand.
Mm-hmm. Well, I would too.
And you see, he's giving him that evil eye too. Like, no, I'm not.
And why would they capture? Did they make a deal about him not shaking it?
I guess. Mm-hmm. Now, this is a sign in a picture of a store in Harlem in the 1960s. Okay? Now, I'm not going to read the whole thing to you, but the drug problem is there, and it says, last warning to all dope peddlers and gangsters. Black, white, Puerto Rican, get out of our Harlem and New York City. But down at the bottom, it says this. Now, listen to this. 1960s. We are calling for federal troops, state and local law enforcement force to move into the streets of Harlem and New York City and clean it up. You notice what I said? Mm-hmm. 1960s, mm-hmm. Send the federal troops, the army.
Yeah.
1960s. Took a little while, but they did it.
They did it. Now, is that scary?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Posse Comitatus.
And this, of course, is Ben Carson. I like what that guy's saying.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Let's move on. We've got more to cover in a little time. Y'all know that Bonner, I call him Bonehead, Bonner quit, he stepped out of as leader of Speaker of the House. And one guy that said was going to take his place apparently had it sewed up and he changed his mind. Now, I wonder why he changed his mind. What's going on? Why did the guy back out?
Because he was told he was going to be killed if he didn't.
But you wouldn't have done it.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't all bad. When Deputy Brian Russell saw Tara Gray and her two young sons asleep in an Ohio Sheriff's Office waiting room, he knew something was wrong. Gray told Russell that they'd been evicted from their home. Eager to help, the big-hearted cop tried to find the family a space in a shelter, but soon discovered they were all full. So Russell booked the family into a hotel for 10 nights and bought them clothes, shoes, and toiletries at a Walmart on his own dime. He's the best, said Gray's 8-year-old son, Zari. He's like your friend to me. That's what mm-hmm. used to be normal. Cops right. had hearts.
Mm-hmm.
Emma Lyon can't read or write, but she hasn't let that hold her back. The 21-year-old Australian who has Down syndrome, hearing loss, and autism has always loved using paper shredders. So with the help of her mother, Jo, she set up a business called Master Shredder, shredding confidential documents for companies that don't want anybody reading their paperwork. She can't read, remember?
Yes.
Lyman now has 4 regular clients, including a credit union and a law firm, and is passionate about her job. She's making a difference in her own life, said the mother, making her way like any other 21-year-old. I don't like that.
Mm-hmm.
Some initiative for a change. Only in America, a California high school student who defended a blind classmate from a bully ended up being suspended for fighting.
Oh, my golly.
Yeah. Video of the incident showed Cody Pine, 17, decking the bully and chastising him for beating up on the visually impaired student. More than 80,000 people signed an online petition in support of Pines, who was suspended after the school's zero-tolerance policy against violence.
25 years ago, Butch, they came up with the idea of if there's a fight, both sides get
punished.
That is promoting bullyism.
It is.
Because there are people who want to get kicked out. They know they can get someone else. And you know, that is where they say they're helping and they're actually hurting. It's just the opposite.
It's also a sissy fine the boys.
You're supposed to get to the truth. And that used to be the principal would call everyone in.
Yep.
He would make a decision. You know, they don't want to do that anymore. It's no. too easy to just say, well, bingo, both of you out, you know.
Yep, unfortunately.
Sickening.
Only America Springfield, Missouri last month updated its indecent exposure laws to require women to cover a greater percentage of their breasts in public in response to the Free the Nipple rallies organized by local feminists. The law requires that both sexes cover 100% of their buttocks, a provision barring display of covered male genitals in a discernibly turd state was removed from the final law. I don't understand. Why did we get this corrupted? They got to pass laws to cover your boobs up and keep your hind end covered.
If you have to legislate morality, you're
in trouble.
You know why a chicken wears feathers? So you can see his underwear.
Well, you said, I never thought of that.
She sent me an article a few days back about, it was in Missouri where they want to make it where the woman can go topless.
Yeah, that's Colorado. Colorado City.
That's Colorado City.
Good week for pencil necks after British researcher discovered. Now, this is good. That pound for pound bodybuilder muscles are weaker than those of people who don't pump iron. Weightlifters, and I always knew that. Nobody believed it. Weightlifters are only strong, scientists said, because they have so much muscle mass, which compensates for their poor muscle quality.
Right.
And that's, I knew that. I've read that before, but anyway.
They told us that years ago.
Yeah. Good week for your it after Washington School District lifted its ban on playing tag during recess following lobbying by parents. School officials in Mercer Island said they had prohibited this game to ensure students' physical and emotional safety. What? Emotional safety? Oh, well. Good week for hot water after Representative Bob Brady, Democrat, Pennsylvania. So, now listen to this. Stole a half-full glass of water that Pope Francis drank from during his address to Congress and used the water to bless his staff and family.
Oh, my God.
Okay. Took water from a holy father?
Yeah.
He's bound for hell.
Oh.
Especially since he claims he's Jesus on earth.
Exactly.
Holy father.
Bad week for bathroom breaks. Emergency bathroom breaks, I should say. After a passenger on Dutch airline KLM was arrested for allegedly trying to open the plane's door at 30,000 feet.
Not a good idea.
No. James Gray said he mistook the exit for their restroom, adding, I realize the danger of that sort of thing. Whoa, watch out first step, boys. Bad week for rummaging after a Florida woman found an 8-foot, 40-pound Burmese python dozing among a pile of clothes at a flea market. Was looking for a cozy place to digest his meal, said the farmer who removed the snake. That's wow.
Yuck.
A Michigan driver with phobia about spiders sparked a raging fire at a gas station when he tried to kill one of the critters with a cigarette lighter.
Oh.
Security footage showed the man filling up his car and then peering inside the fuel door and asking, is that a spider in there? When he lighted his lighter, a blaze suddenly engulfed the car, the pump, and then presumably the spider. The driver put out the flames with a nearby fire extinguisher and returned to his gas station the next day and apologized. He was sorry, said the clerk. Just one of those things that happen. Stupidity.
Jeez. At least you can admit you're stupid.
A California man got much more than he expected when he opened his delivery from Domino's, $1,300 in cash. Instead of a chicken wings he expected, Mike Vegas found two thick stacks of cash inside the box. One contained $666, the other $633. Vegas called the driver, who had meant to take the Mayfield box to the bank. Domino's rewarded Vegas with a year of free pizza. Honest people are hard to find these days, said Domino's manager. So, see, some of them work out good.
There you go.
All right, let's get started more here. Now, there's no other way to call this except America and the Western culture are being invaded by foreigners. Mm-hmm. Now, it's not immigration. We're being invaded. They're not coming in legally. They're coming across the border in swarms. We're being invaded. We're being invaded. You understand that? Mm-hmm. And it weakens our structure when they're invaded by foreigners who don't hold the same beliefs we do and don't abide by the same laws we do and want us to enforce their laws instead of our laws. That's true. Mm-hmm. The Muslims are raping the white Christian women in Europe right now. They're raping them. Oh, yeah, I'm not making it up. They're raping them. And the authorities are doing very little about it. They're raping them. And I'm going to get to make this right. Something like 80% of the invaders are men. Yeah, 80% of the refugees are men. Not women and children, too. 80% are men. Now, why is that?
It's cultural scripted suicide.
Yes, it is. It really is. How do you... How long have we been told that we can put all information on computers, government computers, it's all secure. Nothing nobody can touch it, right? It's all secure.
All secure.
No one can get into it, right? The news from the Office of Personal Management hack keeps getting worse. In addition to the personal record of 20 million U.S. government employees, we've now learned that hackers stole fingerprints of 5.6 million of them. They stole their fingerprints that were scanned and put on computers of almost 6 million people who work for the government. Now, that can't happen in a secure computer, can it, Phil?
Well, it's called Hegelian dialectic. They create the problem, and it's called problem, reaction, solution. They know the reaction, and they'll get their solution. I'd say some of these are just maybe hackers, but a lot of it. Well, think about it. If you're selling a an antivirus and everything program. If there are no viruses out there, you're not going to be doing very well in business. You know, the NRA makes more money when we're losing gun rights.
Yeah, that's very true.
And it's sad that it's, you know, they've got it. It's to their advantage. It's a catch-22.
Let me say something like cancer, more cancer, more to make the cancer society.
So,
have I done with 25 minutes?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, you've gone 37 minutes.
Wow. Anyway, MorphoTrack, a new technology. Guess where? West Virginia.
Oh, Morpho what?
MorphoTrack.
Oh, boy.
The company plans to establish a program management and engineering office at the new facility, for which it will recruit a team of local experienced and well-qualified professionals to manage and support high technology engineering projects. Now, this is going to be retinal scans, more biometrics is going to be scored in West Georgia, just like it's in Fremont right now, in West Virginia. And the goal is, now folks, listen to this, MorphoTrack will launch its video analysis solution, Morpho Video, at the 2015, now pay attention, the 2015 Global Identity Summit.
Oh.
Where's that?
It doesn't say where it's at. It just says that's where they're going
to
take it
to. I'd like to go to that.
2015 Global ID Summit.
I think Catherine Albrecht is going to be there. Don't you figure?
I would think so. Well, I haven't thought about that. Mm-hmm. But is that in your face?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Global ID? Mm-hmm. Feds developed app that predicts psychological status of Americans.
Can we get a free evaluation?
You'll get it whether you want or not. Researchers at the National Institutes of Health have developed a system that can predict the psychological status of users with smartphones and hope to private companies to bring the invention to the market. The technology appeared on a list of NIH inventions published in the Federal Register that are now available to be licensed by private companies. The government allows companies to license inventions resulting from federal research in order to expedite their arrival on the marketplace. The system uses smartphones to ask people how they are doing mentally during the day, and based on the results can deliver an automated intervention if necessary.
Oh my golly.
Huh. Whoa.
Is that your face? The NIH inventors developed a mobile health technology, to monitor and predict a user's psychological status and deliver an automated intervention when needed, according to the notice published Wednesday. The technology uses smartphones to monitor the user's location and ask questions about psychological status throughout the day. Continuously collected ambulatory psychological data are fused with data on location responses to questions. The mobile data are combined with risk maps to quantify exposure to risk and predict a future psychological state. You can go nuts next week,
You mean like if somebody asks me how you doing, I gotta say, wait, let me check my
check your phone. The future predictions. Now pay attention. This is minority effect. Mm-hmm. Minority report. The future predictions are used to warn the user when he or she is especially high risk of experiencing a negative event that might lead to an unwanted outcome, i.e. lapse to a drug use in a recovering addict. The NIH said that the technology has potential commercial applications for real-time behavioral monitoring and therapeutic delivery of an intervention via a mobile device.
I know what it's going to say.
So that
warning, Will Robinson.
There you go, yeah.
So we're looking at this device that can actually read, or it says it can read your emotions, your feelings.
Sure.
It sends it off to a hub. Oh, this person's experiencing mental illness. All of a sudden, here comes a little truck with about three guys in it. Put this in a bag.
In little white jackets.
Wearing white coats. And here we are off to one of the...
To help us.
Many
it's to help us.
Help centers.
Go to the funny farm.
Researchers developed a system from a project to track the mood. It tracked the mood and cravings of drug users in Baltimore. The 8.9 million federal study sought to develop algorithms that could automatically detect behavioral events such as episodes of drug use or stress without requiring self-report. There it is.
Well, I do think they need some kind of invention, because when I try to text, I realize I got dumb fingers. They're too big.
Yeah.
My dumb fingers mine. I got the same problem. Operate a smartphone. Yeah. I need dumb fingers.
We need a keyboard or that big on the phone. Yeah, there you go.
You need a smartphone like we have. All we do is push this little button and we speak into it.
Are you serious?
Oh, you can talk to mine.
I can probably talk to mine.
You can talk into my Android and it'll tell you that you can talk the whole text message.
Yeah, you can.
And then, you know, check it over, make sure everything's right, because sometimes it gets the wrong word. And hit send, and it's gone. You don't even have to type it.
Phil, I sent this to you. You have it on video.
Please.
What's that say?
Will robots in our brains, be godlike?
Hmm. You see that? This is Google exec. With robots in our brains, will be godlike.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Now, this is a fact, folks.
Well, since our leadership is godlike, we should join them, shouldn't we?
Of course.
Yeah.
Who would be fascinated by the idea of becoming someone other than themselves? Who would like to be other than me? Who's better looking than I am? That's anyway.
I am.
You look in the mirror like me? But anyway.
I'd rather go for money than look.
There you go. We do get so tired of being the same dull soul every day. Now, folks, listen. This is for real. What kind of robots will we be? Happily, I can provide an answer. For living inside my head all day have been the words of Google's Director of Engineering, Ray Kurzweil. I don't know what that means. He's been keen on humans going over to the bright side. He's predicted that all humans will be hybrid robots by 2030.
Actually, I think he's stretching it. I think it's going to be just a priority, people. You know, most of us aren't going to make it, Butch.
No, I know that. Well, that's a long ways off for us anyway. But you stop thinking about this a second. One of the last shows on Star Trek was a man mating with a computer.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Mm-hmm. DARPA implanting computer chips in soldiers' brains. We knew this. Now it's out. Melding artificial silicone with breathing tissue is no longer fantasy peddled by science fiction writers. That is at least what New York Times bestselling author and journalist Annie Jackson reports. In her new book, The Pentagon's Brain, Jacobson argues that DARPA had been secretly implanting computer chips in the soldiers' brains in order to treat trauma and boost performance on the battlefield. Now, folks, I'm not going to read the article. I don't have time. But this is all in writing. This will probably be in a magazine soon. It says in May 2014, the Pentagon announced that it was working to develop brain-computer chips using money from a research program dedicated to building new, minimally invasive neurotechnologies. Nevertheless, Jacobson claims that DARPA is already planting these brain chips in the wounded soldiers coming back from the Middle East. Now, this is a fact. Now, I want to show you something that I showed this church 20 years ago. 20 years ago.
I think it's Roborats?
Yeah, Roborats. This is the Worldwide Weekly Defense News on March 26, 1995. Okay, you see that? That's mm-hmm. what it is, all right? I had this laminated. I don't know why I feel like I should keep this, but I did laminate it. Yeah. 20 years ago, Steve Abraham gave us to remember Steve? By the way, Steve's in pretty sure condition. My heart's going way up. This says, what's this area terror joke? Can you see that?
Naval Research Lab attempts to mold neurons and chips.
20 years ago.
Yeah.
They said 20 years ago, we're going to have an army of zombies, an army of robots.
Yeah.
20 years ago, right there.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And here it is today, 20 years later, happening. Now, we said this 20 years ago on the radio, and somebody said, everybody thought I was nuts. I'm making it up. How can I make that up? I'm not that smart.
No, that's in black and white.
Now, on the back side, what's that say, Phil?
Researchers combine biology and computers.
Mm-hmm. 20 years ago. And they told me I was crazy. This can't happen.
Yeah. I wish you had.
It's here. Oh, me too. Yeah. But Phil, how much clearer can it be? Look at the articles. Here it is. All of it in front of us. I'm not a prophet, but folks, I read, I study, and here it is. Is this the Mark the Beast technology?
Yes.
Yeah, plus when they get done with them, it'll be awful easy to kill them, too.
And I still say the one thing that I couldn't understand in the Bible where it said they'll want to die and they can't.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
If you become a part of this computer board, you won't be able to die. If you upload your download your consciousness into the board, that's eternal.
Yeah.
And that's hell. That's
no
hell
doubt.
Because if it isn't heaven, it's hell.
Now, just, Lord, thank you for vindicating your servants. But 20 years ago, we talked about this. And I felt that led by the Spirit, Joe, to laminate this and keep it. Now do you see why I did it?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. I didn't know this was going to happen 20 years later.
But you knew they were working on it.
Absolutely.
And, you know, 20 years ago, computers were still kind of in the preemie stage.
Yeah, really. They were.
Lynn found I found the book. I was about to burn it in the woodshed, and it had a teacher's name who teaches in this county, who teaches math. And he and I went to West Liberty College at the same time. And it was a book about Fortran programming. And inside the book, it had his name and the Bartel, the hall where he lived and everything. And there was one of those punch cards. And that's how you used to put your program into a computer. It was a bunch of cards with holes in it.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
You know? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I remember seeing that.
I mean, it was so, you know, just look how much has changed. When you see that card with holes, you know, it looks like a, you know, voting.
I'll bet back in the 60s, they showed us computers bigger than this room.
Oh, yeah.
And all those pools around. Talk about the technology they had to do all this stuff. And now there's more in your pocket computer than there is one of those roomful. In Illinois, the police have got a new program out. Police enter unlocked vehicles to remind you to lock up under new gotcha program. They open the car up. They put it's only half a picture. They open up and they put a little orange sticker inside your car that says, "We got you. Let your car unlock."
Whoa. So what are they saying? Oh, we can rob you no matter what?
Well, it says that...
You're being told you should have locked your car.
Yeah, somebody can steal all your car. So cops open, put a sign that says, we're just taking your... They didn't. We just took your stereo because the door's unlocked. Please lock your doors. Mm-hmm. We need all the help we can get, boys. Of course, Hillary said this, and I'm going to take time to go there. Hillary said, "I'm coming for the guns."
She changed her mind since that one, yesterday.
What'd she say yesterday?
She took it back or something. Was that yesterday?
No, this was October 5th.
Okay. I didn't listen to the whole thing.
So anyway, come and get them. Mm-hmm. I don't know what else I can say. Come on.
Well, they have to come and get them in order to let Russia come into the country and take us down.
Obama goes beyond mere gun control, hence a confiscation. I'm going to tell you, Obama said this. Listen to this. Now, I want this very carefully. We know that other countries, in response to one mass shooting, have been able to craft laws that eliminate mass shootings. Friends of ours, allies of ours, Great Britain, Australia, countries like ours, so we know there are ways to prevent it. What did Australia do? They took every gun they had, dump load trucks of them, destroyed them. Remember that?
Australia? Oh, yeah, our Marines were helping.
Yeah, they were.
They had 8,000 or 9,000 U.S. Marines.
Great Britain did the same thing, took all guns from the civilians. Obama said, "We can do that here. We've got to be like our friends."
And Australia today is starting to allow the citizens to have guns again.
And still
after they took millions and millions of them. Now, new school policy here. School students ask, now I'm not making this up. I got that right here. School students ask for number of guns, political views held by family.
Ooh.
Now listen to some of the questions on this form they fill out in school. How's your name and grade? Does your family own guns? If so, how many? What is their purpose? Self-defense, hunting, other sports, others, please describe. Have you ever fired a gun? If so, what context? Hunting, school range, shooting range, other. What do you associate with guns? Protection, dangerous, safety, law enforcement, hunting, sports, freedom, fear, military, fun. Which do you support? No limits on gun ownership, some limits on gun ownership, moderate limits on gun ownership, strict limits on gun ownership, or total prohibition of guns? Hmm. On a scale of 1 to 10, where 1 equals strong liberal and 10 strong conservative, what are your parents' political views? What are your political views? Have you or anyone in your family ever used a gun in a self-defense situation? If so, describe.
That's what it's for, self-defense.
What grade and where is that?
That's, let's see, Texas. Henderson High School, Texas. Texas. Pope says weapon manufacturers can't call themselves Christians.
Mm-hmm.
People who manufacture weapons or invest in weapons industries are hypocrites if they call themselves Christians, says Pope Francis on last Sunday.
Oh, my God.
And why didn't he speak out against murdered babies and homosexuality?
He had a chance before.
Doesn't he have armed guards?
He does. He had a chance before the U.S. Congress and the U.N. to denounce abortion, murdering babies, sodomy, and yet he talked about capitalism and guns.
Yeah.
But you know, before he became a Catholic priest, he was a bouncer in a bar.
I don't doubt that.
He was. They said that was what he done. He was a bouncer.
One in three Americans own guns. One in three Americans own guns, but here's the part I like. There are five states in the whole country where gun ownership is over 50%. Ours is one of them. We're the only one on the East Coast. Wow. Our gun ownership is over 50% of people in this country, in this state, own guns.
Yeah.
Montana looks like,
Wyoming.
Wyoming.
Not California.
And Idaho.
Not California.
Not California, you know.
What about Florida?
And Arkansas, by the way, and then West Virginia.
It doesn't look like Florida.
But Florida is about 30%.
30%, okay.
Now look at that. And the lowest crime rates have to be in certain states. I wonder which ones. Mm-hmm. Anyway, we'll move on.
It should be 100%.
Yeah, it should be. I got to read this to you. I know we're not time, but it's okay because we've got a lot to cover. If you didn't get to hear last time, we'll be here next week doing it again. We'll show some videos probably. I thought this is entitled My Gun. Today I swung my front door wide open and placed my Remington 12-gauge semi-automatic shotgun right in the doorway. I left 9 shells beside it, then left it alone and went about my business. While I was gone, the mailman delivered my mail, the neighbor boy across the street mowed the yard, a girl walked her dog down the street, and quite a few cars stopped at the stop sign near the front of my house. After about an hour, I checked on the gun. It was still sitting there right where I left it. It hadn't moved itself. It certainly hadn't killed anyone. So even with the numerous opportunities it had presented to do so, in fact, it hadn't even loaded itself. Well, you can imagine my surprise with all the hype by the left and the media about how dangerous guns are and how they kill people. Well, either the media is wrong, or I'm in possession of the latest gun in the world. The United States is 30 in murders throughout the world. But if you take out just four cities, Detroit, Chicago, Washington, D.C., and New Orleans, the United States is fourth from the bottom in the entire world for murders. Think about that. And the strictest gun laws are in those cities. These four cities also have the toughest gun laws in the U.S. All four of these cities are controlled by Democrats. It would be absurd to draw any conclusions from that data, right? Well, I'm off to check on my spoons. I hear they're making people fat.
Not teaspoons, just a tablespoon.
Tablespoons.
Yeah.
The Supreme Court has ruled that mandatory vaccinations are not unconstitutional.
They own your bodies, Buzz. Right?
Yep, they did. The U.S. Supreme Court has refused to hear a case challenging the state of New York's public school vaccination requirement, which requires all children to be vaccinated prior to attendance at public school. The SCOTUS failure to hear the case effectively states that mandatory vaccinations of all public school children doesn't violate their constitutional rights.
Well, they can just say what they want, but it's not what I'm going to do.
What did I just tell you? Now, we'll get in the next hour's lesson, not this week probably, but too much to get into, but vaccinations is a sign of ownership.
Sure is.
And a mandatory vaccination for adults is starting to happen in this country.
I read to you a minute ago a sign in 1960 in New York City where they want federal troops in to take the peace, right? Obama administration, UN announced global police force to fight extremism in U.S. cities. Obama is going to bring in the federal troops into U.S. cities.
That's his plan, of course.
Now, I don't know, 1960s, 50 years later, 1995, 20 years later,
well, Kissinger said if there was a big enough problem, the Americans would welcome UN troops in their cities.
The University of Minnesota just purchased fetal tissue from a provider featured in one of the videos released by the Center for Medical Progress. Copies of the purchase orders, which span from 2008 to 2014, reveal that the university has purchased numerous body parts procured from abortion clinics. The purchase of body parts included 16 24-week-old fetal pancreas, 16, 22-week-old fetal lung, and second trimester fetal liver and thymus. Universities are buying murdered baby parts to teach in these colleges.
I think it's called not higher education, that's lower education.
Demoting education.
Mother commits child abuse by giving her son estrogen. Many women are afraid to take estrogen during menopause because of self-documented cancer risk. But one woman is being applauded on social media for giving her son estrogen so he can live his childhood fantasy of being a girl. And you got to be on that too somewhere. The poor boy in the video is going through life with artificially induced breast and a penis. No woman is going to want him. His only chance for companionship will be through anal sex with men. He will go through life scaring girls in locker rooms and elevating himself and being elevated from society. And that's the best case scenario if he doesn't get cancer. I sent that to you. The boy's picture is on there. The mothers give him estrogen to help him do that. State using taxpayer funds to implant 10-year-olds with birth control. 10 years old?
10.
10 years old. 10 years old, I didn't know about sex. I knew girls smelled good and they looked pretty. But I didn't know about that. Did you, Joe? 10 years old?
10-year-old.
Taxpayers in the state of Washington are funding the disturbing practice of fitting extremely young public school girls with implantable, long-lasting birth control devices, according to documents received by the conservative watchdog group Judicial Watch. Girls as young as 10 attending public schools in Seattle have been implanted with intrauterine devices, IUDs, the documents show, and as exposed by Life News in July, the children do not need to obtain parents' permission before the procedure is performed.
Oh, my golly.
Phil, what's that promoting?
I'm sorry, I'm watching the internet.
Oh, okay. Is it working?
Right now it's having a problem.
All right, I've got to move on here. But the university, let's see, what school is this? UCSB, what is that?
UCSB,
what is it? I've read it, I forgot because it's been so much. Oh, the University of California, Santa Barbara is now using the Bible to show that, it says that at the University Safe Zone project says students should keep their religious beliefs themselves when a friend or family member comes out. The Bible is going to be taught that it is not against homosexuality. Take the Bible and try to prove that God does not disapprove of homosexuality. I don't know what Bible they got, but it's not the one I read.
No. All they did is just saying that God can't find his butt with both of his hands, and they're all wrong.
The ACLU is now suing Catholic hospitals because they will not enforce the abortion laws in the Obama mandates in the health care affair. They won't do it. So ACLU is suing them. Catholic hospitals. Is that an attack upon religious beliefs?
Well, ACLU, Anti-Christ Liberty Union.
Yeah. Caitlyn Jenner claims she no longer feels like a woman and asked everyone to call her Bruce again.
What?
Yeah. Now, that didn't make the news, did it?
No.
I haven't heard people news about that, have you? But apparently, the thing has changed its mind and said, I don't want a woman anymore. I was wrong. I'm a man.
Okay.
But that didn't make the news, Phil.
He went through his stardom.
Well, maybe you'll figure out what the opposite sex is all about now.
It's amazing, though, how it's all over the news when he decides to be a woman, but when he decides he was wrong, that one peep.
It's not going to be,
A guy who owns a club in, this is in Oregon. It's Oregon, Portland, Oregon. A guy who owned a club, and it started some transgenders started coming in there and meeting there. Well, he started losing business because everybody thought it was a tranny bar. Nobody wanted to be there. So he started losing business. So he said, he banned him from his business. He had been fined $400,000 because he wouldn't let him come in.
Oh, my golly.
Yeah. Is that an attack on another guy for his beliefs?
Yes.
Do you think persecution of Christians is starting in this country? Do you believe it is?
Starting. It's pretty low.
Yeah.
It's on its way.
I'm not going to get into all details with this, but the man just got fired for recommending a Christian movie to a lesbian co-worker.
Recommending?
Yep.
Oh, my God.
That's bad. Just think how powerful political correctness is.
Oh, yes.
More powerful than the church, that's for sure.
And they can say anything they want.
Yeah, they can. Colorado City to allow women to go topless. I was going to move, Marsh said I couldn't. No, anyway, there it is.
Topless in the street?
Public.
Why would you want to do that?
I don't know. Free the nipple.
Because they want to be, I read the article, because they want to be like, if the men can take their shirts off, we can
equal
do
equal rights.
Well, they shouldn't down the street. That's just respect.
Mm-hmm. You come a long way, baby.
Just move to France. I mean, they have nudist beaches. I mean, you know.
I mean, that's the one fellow who said he worked for the construction company. He said, none of my men who work for me, we all wear the clothing,
yep.
We don't have piercings, we are respectful on your property.
I told my sons, you do not go in public without a shirt on. Don't do it. No. Don't walk down the streets. Don't do it. It's wrong.
Right.
And Jamie's the one that had the hardest time convincing that. So Jamie, it's just immoral. It's not right to go out in public without a shirt on.
No.
Period.
Well, the business is saying no shirt, no shoes, no service.
Obama's a Christian. Sodomy is more important than religious freedom. Now, I'm going to read to you what Obama said. Now, you pay attention to this. As Pope Francis flew back to Rome, President Obama issued a stern warning to Christians. Stern warning to Christians. Warning them that their attempts to assert their religious liberty to oppose gay rights would fail. We affirm, now please, folks, listen to this. Please.
Who's we?
Obama. We affirm that we cherish our religious freedom and are profoundly respectful of religious traditions. There's a word I like to say there, but I won't. It's BS.
Traditions.
He insisted during a dramatic speech at the LGBT fundraiser in New York City on Sunday night, praising the progress made on gay rights under his administration. But we also, now pay attention, because this is coming from your so-called leader. But we also have to say clearly that our religious freedom doesn't grant us the freedom to deny our fellow Americans their constitutional rights. U.S. companies are swiftly adding health insurance benefits for employees who want to transition to another gender. Which is a picture of Bruce Caitlin. But anyway, it says the U.S. companies are going to start paying for their employees to become whatever they want to be.
To become a what?
To be anything. A man or woman, they can change their sex if you want to. Insurance pay for it.
Well, I'm part-time. I don't get insurance. So I don't have to worry
about it. Did we not say that pedophilia is going to be coming on guard?
Yes. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. This was in Salon magazine. They found it at salon.com. I'm just going to be part of it. I'm a pedophile, but I'm not a monster. I'm attracted to children, but unwilling to act on it. Before judging me harshly, will you be willing to listen? And almost most people are going to say, yeah, I'll listen to you. Share with me why you want to rape my son. This was in Salon magazine.
I don't want to hear any more of that.
Yeah.
I tell him to listen, hear the gun go off.
What did I find here? I'm gonna get to, I missed one somewhere here.
What's the Bible say about if you harm the children?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Those who offended children better have millstone cast around, tied around the neck and cast into the deepest of seas. Mm-hmm. That means you become a reprobate and there's no hope for you.
There's one I want to find. Okay, it's not further here. Anyway, churches are paying the government up to $100 a month to spy on families.
What?
Yeah.
That's called the clergy response team.
According to the Arizona Department of Child Safety, document churches are working with social workers to spy on families as they're also using child safety and risk assessments. According to Tucson.com article, church leaders are openly encouraged to collaborate with the government. The article goes on to explain how religious organizations will spy on families and help the government decide whether they should remove the child from the family. It's called the Care Portal. Care Portal. It's run by the Global Orphan Project.
Better tell Natalie about that one.
My neighbor got a big receipt to get the state police first of the week, 11 o'clock at night. He stopped down there at the Hallmark. And his two kids were fighting. He got them out of the vehicle, smacked the button. Palmar called the state police. They got CPS at 11 o'clock the other night. They came up and talked to him and his children.
They had to wait till 11 at night when everyone was asleep.
Yeah.
Italian priest Don Dino Flam defends pedophiles and blames love-seeking children. An Italian priest has been suspended from his parish after defending pedophilia on live television, attempting to blame victims for seeking affection. Now listen to this.
Mm-hmm.
Don Gino Flam, F-L-A-I-M, of the San Giuseppe and Pio X Parish in the northern Italian town of Trento, claimed on air that he understands pedophilia, whereas I'm not sure about homosexuality. Unfortunately, there are children who seek affection because they don't receive it at home and understand that some priests can give up, he said on Live 7 channel. Pedophilia is a sin, and like all sins, has to be accepted.
What?
But that's what he said. Went on affirming that homosexuality is a disease. The statement comes as Pope Francis. Anyway, going on 3 years.
Sin.
So it's sin, so you can't help it, accept it. I told you it's coming. Didn't I say that?
Mm-hmm. The wages of sin is death.
Lesbian Swedish bishop wants Christian crosses removed from church to please Muslims.
Yeah.
With hundreds of thousands and more migrants set to pour into Sweden, the bishop in Stockholm has proposed removing crosses from the Christian church and replacing them with Islamic symbols in order to cater to for Muslims. Bishop Eva Brun, she's a lesbian now, wants to remove Christian symbols from the Seamen's Church to make the building more inviting for Muslims. Leasing a room to people of other faiths does not mean that we are defenders of our own faith. Priests are called to proclaim Christ. We do that every day in every meeting with people. But that does not mean that we are hostile toward people of other faiths, said Brun, attempting to justify the plan.
She might have to leave the cross up.
And, of course, the Pope said Christ failed on the cross.
He what?
He said Christ failed on the cross.
Failed.
This is what he said. This is his quote.
He said that. I never heard that.
God sees to the fruits of our labors. And if at times our efforts and works seem to fail and not to produce fruit, now pay attention. We need to remember that we are followers of Jesus Christ and his life, humanly speaking, ended in failure, the failure of the cross. So we're going to close on that. We're going to take a few minutes break and back and start the Bible study. But there's been enough right here again in this one teaching, Kelly, to show the proof. Anybody that wants to see it in the world, mm-hmm. where we're headed. The beast system gaining ground every day. Mm-hmm. Sodom and Gomorrah multiplying sins throughout the world. That's us.
Yeah.
Is there not enough proof right here today to show where America is and what's going on? Mm-hmm. Any comments? See you back in a little bit.